Good morning, everybody. Hello. Good morning. Good morning. We slowly start. So unfortunately, I can't see you. I don't know who you are. If you have any questions, always feel free to type into the chat. We will see that and can reply there. Also, if you can't hear me properly or anything doesn't work. What you need? You need a cushion for an exercise at the end, for a stretching exercise. So get a cushion, and the other thing is the playlist would be nice if you could use, if we could all use the same playlist. It is described in the description. It's called I Got Your Back Minus Livestream, and you can find it on Spotify. You have the best quality, I think, if you listen to the playlist from another device, from your phone or something, so you can hear my voice from your computer. So we start sitting, just find a comfortable seat. I wait one more minute. So you have everything ready you need. This class is called I Got Your Back. I'm a physiotherapist and I'm doing this for 1.5 years now. I have normally 2 classes at Fenritz Gym and now this live stream on Tuesday mornings. We have every week a focus. So the main topic is a healthy back. Which includes all, so the training always includes a lot of core training and mobility, stability exercises. This week's focus will be on the low back and the glutes. I think we start slowly, so please, everybody, start your playlist. And I hope you have fun, I hope you can hear me, let's get started. Just sit comfortably, let your soles touch, grab your ankles, have your hips nice and soft. We first start to warm up a bit. So from here, stay soft in your back and just pull yourself forward. Look up if you want, coming forward, breathing deeply. And then breathing out, drop back, get all nice and round. Grab your ankles, have your arms straight, like really drop back nice and relaxed. Breathing in, come forward, keep your elbows down and close to your body. Feel your chest opening, look up. And breathing out, drop back, get all nice and round, arms are straight, let your head drop. So here we don't want much muscle activity, just try to stay soft, pull yourself forwards towards your ankles, chest forward, look up, and then drop back. Engage everything you have, so from your pelvis, roll backwards, be all nice and round, let your head drop. And when we come into extension, feel your pelvis roll in front, and look up to the ceiling. And drop back again, nice and soft. It's like you hang on to your ankles. Let everything drop backwards without strength in your trunk. We do 3 more times here, so come forward. Always continue your own breathing rhythm. When we come forward, we breathe in. And when we go back, breathe out, drop back. Two more here. Make sure you keep your elbows really close. If they're open, you tend to get round. So just keep them close to your waist, look up, and drop back. And one last time here, come forward. If you can, try to stay soft in your hips as well. Let them drop all the time. And one last time, drop backwards or nice and round. And then come back to the middle. So middle means that when you go from side to side like that, you feel the 2 sitting bones. Try to sit nicely on both of them and we open to the side. So put your right hand beside you, open your waist. Push your left sitting bone down, don't let it lift. So we really open nicely here the inside of our waist, the deep muscle quadratus lumborum. We want to get to in the middle, lengthen. And with this length, come to the side. Put the hand beside you. Try to not turn here. So really stay in the side bend and push your right hip down. Don't let your bum cheek lift. We do two more each side. Imagine always when you come back to the middle that here's a thread pulling you up. Stay nice and long in your spine and then come to the side. Also here if you can, don't lift your hips. Push your left sitting bone down onto the mat and change. Nice side bend. Keep your shoulder away from your ear. Try to not pull up here. Stay long in your neck. Also don't let it drop. Stay aligned. And then we do one last time each side. Very nice. Back to the middle, lengthen, stay long, and to the side. From here, come back to the middle. Find your two sitting bones again. Breathe into your belly deeply. Lengthen your left arm. When you breathe out, come into rotation. So look behind you. We stay here for three breaths. Make sure that you keep your weight on both sitting bones. The other hand is close to your seat and push yourself a bit further into the twist while you breathe out. Again, engage your neck. So look over your back shoulder with your eyes. One more breath here. So also the neck will be engaged in this twist. And slowly release. Come back to the middle, change side. Breathe into your belly real deep. Lengthen your right arm. And when you breathe out, then come into the twist. Put the hand on the opposite knee and look behind you. We stay here for three breaths. Make sure your two bum cheeks are rounded, hands close to your seat. Stay nice and straight and use your breathing out to go a little bit further. Engage your neck. Look over your back shoulder as far as you can. Then slowly release. Come back to the middle. Cross your feet and roll over your feet so we can come to stand. From here, let your head drop. Feet are parallel, nicely grounded. Let your head drop, hang out your neck. Let your arms hang forward. Try to just hang out here. The knees are slightly bent, so we don't need the stress in the hamstrings here. Just hang out your neck and then roll up vertebra by vertebra. And we go forwards for three times. So from the top of your head, roll in. Nice and precise, vertebra by vertebra. Make sure you let your head really drop forward. Arms are nice and heavy. Feel the weight of your head pulling forward. And then roll up again, vertebra by vertebra. And we do two more forwards like that from the top of your head, rolling. The legs are all the time slightly bent. Focus is on the neck, let your head drop like that. We already try to create some traction on our spine to release the structures in between the vertebrae. Create some space. One last time, forward. From the top of your head, roll in. Again, use your breath to let go more. Let your head drop. Check on your shoulders and neck with every breath out. And then roll up again. Only lift your head at last. Perfect. And then we come into the middle. So come into this position, please. Knees are under, heels are under your knees. So here we are already strengthening isometrically our glutes and thighs. Just stay strong here. Don't move your legs. Stay nice and low. The bum should be almost at the height of the knees. Make sure you are in a good alignment of your knees. So really heels under the knees. Stay here, nice and low. And then we move from the chest, come forward into extension again. Look up. and then drop back. Let your chest drop back, get all nice and round. We do 7 here, so chest forward, feel your shoulders roll back and down, and roll back. Make sure the movement happens from your chest, and you don't bend forward here too much. So chest forward, open until your fingertips look up, and then drop back again. If you can, take your head with you. So third time, come forward, look up, and round up. So again, try to check on your hips. They shouldn't be bending at this exercise, just our upper back is moving, and in our lower body, we hold nice and strong. And 5. Stay nice and low. I can't see you, but don't get weak. Stay there. And 6. Also check on your shoulders that you don't pull them up. Keep them nicely away from your ears. Last time, just forward, open and round. Very nice. From here, feet parallel, hang down. Let your head drop one more time. Shake out your legs if you want. And then we bend our knees for 3 times. So bend your left. And straight to warm up the inside of our thighs. So bend the right. And straight. If you can, please let your feet down. So 2 more each side. And change. And 1 last time, bend your left. And straight, bend your right. Very nice, straight, back to the middle, roll up like in the beginning. Only lift your head at last, and we come back into the same position again. So nice and low, check on your heels below your knees. Pull your belly button in and up, so you are nice and upright in your whole body. Stay low. This time we move to the side. So if you straighten your arms like that, flex your wrist, get your fingertips, pull up. So we open our forearms here. Stay, shoulder down. And then we move to the side. Go nice and far as you can. Imagine you stand between 2 glass windows. So again, you can't move forward, okay? Just stay in this nice horizontal movement. Arms are parallel to the floor. Remember to pull your fingertips up. Keep your shoulders down. And we do 3 more here. So this week's playlist is a bit cheesier. I hope you like it, but I love this song. Hope you have fun. 1 more. Go nice and far. And far. And back to the middle. Hang down 1 more time. Shake out your head, shake out your legs. And we twist again. So take your right hand to the outside of your left leg and come into the twist. Let your head drop towards your knee. Feet are nicely on the floor, especially the outside of your foot is down. The upper hand is just slightly pulling up to the ceiling. And pull yourself towards your knee. This time, the legs are both straight and hips in the middle. Stay here for 2 more breaths. Then slowly release, change side. Left hand to the outside of your right leg and open to the side. The upper hand is just slightly pulling up to the ceiling. More important is our hand on the leg. So pull yourself towards your knee. Make sure you don't let your feet lift, push the outside of your foot down. Make sure the legs are straight, hips in the middle. And 1 more nice and deep breath here. And then slowly release, come back to the middle, roll up. Very nice. So next round we'll be squatting. This time we are hip width apart and parallel. Make sure, so this is mainly about the stability of our legs. So make sure you send them straight forward. Don't let them go in or outside. We do 3 sets of squats, 10 squats, with 1 stability exercise for the neck in between. So get nice and parallel. We start together. And 1 and 2. Make sure the weight is on the whole foot. So don't let your heels lift or your toes. And we lift our arms to help us get our chest up and be nice and long in the whole spine. Check. Pull your belly button slightly in and up. Don't let it drop forward. And 2 more here. Even though you lift your arm, try to keep your shoulders down. And 1 last time here. And then 1 step forward, hips are parallel, arms beside your face, out of the shoulders, real quick movements, like that, look forward, make sure it's not here, it's not from the wrist, out of the shoulders for 5 more, 4, 3, 2, 1, release, next round, back into squatting, feet parallel hip width apart, und 1, und 2. So feel into your belly. You don't want to let it fall forward like that. Pull your belly button in towards your spine. And 5. And 6. And 7. And 8. And 9, and 10. Very nice. 1 step forward, hips parallel, arms beside your face. 1 last round, out of the shoulders, nice and fast, like 2 straight sticks, really quicker. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release. 1 last round. Get back into parallel again. Make sure you stay aligned in your legs, in your knees. 10 more here. So normally in class, of course, I can see everybody nicely. There's always someone who's lifting their heels. If you feel that you are also more on your toes with your weight, then think you want to sit back on a really low sofa, okay? And then you get your weight better on the back of your foot. And 2 more here. And 1 more. Perfect. Then last round of the stabilizing exercise for the neck. Arms beside your face for 10. Quick. Arms are straight. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release. So while we do that, so in order to not do this automatically, we have to do a little counter movement really from the inside of our neck, which is working the small muscles close to our spine to help us stabilize our vertebrae in the neck. We continue with planking. So from here, we roll down 1 more time. Let your knees be bent, grab your elbows and swing from side to side. Last time, hang out your spine. And then put your hand down, walk forward into high plank. Make sure your hands are beneath your shoulders. Spread your fingers, push into your fingertips. Find the perfect plank, so try to be not with your bums in the air, but on the height of your shoulders, neck is long. Stay with your shoulders above your hands, and now nice and slow, come with your knee to your elbow and change. We do 3 reps each side. Nice and slow over the outside. And 2. And change. And 3. And change. From here, elbows close to your body, come onto your belly. Straighten your feet, push into your feet, and feel your kneecaps are lifting off. Then pull your shoulder blades back and down. Release. 5 reps here and 2. Make sure you keep your feet stuck on the floor. Don't let them lift. And 3. So this is about the quality of the movement. We want to activate our lower trapezius here. So roll your shoulder blades nicely back and down. Imagine you want to push your shoulder blade into your back pocket of your jeans. So the left shoulder blade wants to go into the right pocket. Make sure you don't lift your feet. I can feel you, some of you are lifting. One last time. Then hands beside your chest, tuck your toes in, sit back onto your heels, landing them for a moment. So either here you put your head down, or if you want to extend your upper back, then look forward. We do one more round of each exercise. Come back into high plank. Again, make sure your whole weight is not here on the wrist, so you spread your fingers wide and push into the fingertips as if you want to make holes into the carpet. 3 more reps each side. And change. So here it's important that you don't let this happen. Don't let your shoulders sway forward. And change. And one more. And change. Now in a plank, elbows close to your body. Come onto your belly. Straighten your feet. Push into the back of your foot. So your kneecaps are lifting off. Check. Hold that. 5 reps. Shoulder blades back and down. Release. So by activating this lower trapezius part, we are also helping to release our chest, actually. These muscles are kind of opponents, so this has many good reasons to do that. Also, if you are here normally training at Fenrir's gym, you do a lot of grappling, many martial arts fighters have, or practitioners have, tight pecs, so remember of working your lobe, your mid back. Hands beside your chest, tuck your toes in, sit back onto your heels. And we come into planking here, come onto your elbows. One nice line in your body. Neck is long, in line with your spine. Find a perfect plank, bums down. And then from here, we lift one foot after the other. So again, it's about the quality. Don't lift high, but make sure that you don't move in your trunk. So try to not wobble around here. You really don't have to lift much in the feet, but stay strong in your trunk. For 3 more. And change, 2 more, change, 1 more, change, back to the middle, knees down, sit back onto your heels. Next round, side plank, come onto your side. Again, watch your alignment, elbows beneath the shoulder, be on one nice line. One foot is in front, top foot can be in front. We lift for 10 and we hold for 10. Und 1, 2, 3. Make sure you keep your neck here. Don't let your head drop. And 6. Nice up and down. Don't rest in between. And 9, 10. Stay here if you want to straighten your arm. Make sure you keep your fingers above you. Don't let them drop behind so you're nice and aligned. 3 more. 2, 1. And change side. Get nice and comfy, all on one line. Elbow beneath your shoulder, top foot in front. We lift for 10. Und 1, 2, 3. The whole way. Don't rest in between. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hold here, arms above. Imagine your fingertips pull you up. So you have your shoulders nice and stacked and the hips nice and stacked. 3, 2, 1, release, and come onto your back. We continue to working on our core, more more now on our belly muscles, actually outside belly muscles. So we are doing sit-ups. Make sure you have your neck nice aligned. So like that, we just lift the shoulder girdle like that. We do 10 to the middle and then lie on your side, turn to the foot, and then we do 10 to the side like that. I won't do the straight belly muscles because I'm pregnant, so don't get confused. You have to do them. Let's come into the middle and get ready. We lift for 10 und 1, 2, 3, 4, keep your neck straight. 8, 9, 10. Then lie on your side, turn to your foot und 1, 2. Here we are working the obliques, die schrägen Bauchmuskeln. Get up towards your foot. I'm allowed to do that. Und 8, 9, 10. Change side. So for the obliques, lie on your side like you're in bed. Turn to the foot und up. 2, 3, 4. Make sure your leg is nice and active. The knee is bent, the foot is bent. 10. Back onto the back. So we do 4 rounds all in all, so 3 more. Little break, take a nice breath, and then let's get back to the middle. Feet are grounded. Und 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Continue. 8, 9, 10. Lie on your side. Turn to the foot und up. 2, 3. So don't use any oomph. I always see someone in class doing this. Ugh. Try to not do that, just small movements. Change side. Think small movement with strength, no oomph, rather small. Just lift off your shoulder girdle. 8, 9, 10, little break. If you want, let both knees drop to one side so you can nicely release a bit in your low back and your belly, then come back to the middle. 10 again. Und 1, 2, 3, 4, nice and parallel in the neck. 7, 8, 9, 10. Well done. On the side, turn to the foot. Und 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Keep your leg nice and active. 8, 9, 10. Change side. Turn to the foot. Und 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Last break, last round. Relax, one moment. Back to the middle. Und 1, 2, 3, 4. Continue. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. On the side. Und 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Don't pull on your head like me. 9, 10. Change side. Last round. Stay there. Only 10 more. Und 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well done. Back onto the back. Let your knees drop. We roll out our backs. Take your knees towards you. By the way, 120. Well done. It's always easier, quicker actually, than you think. Grab your knees, take some oomph, and roll out your back. Just 5 times. Roll a bit over your own back, like a little self massage. You can use your knees to really pull yourself up. Try to stay nice and soft. And one more. The next time we land cross-legged, roll over into tabletop. And from here we come back on working on our glutes again. So this time we do, we show from here into extension. So heel to the ceiling, 10. And then outwards for the abductors, the muscles here. Both muscle groups are important for the stability of our pelvis, so as a basis for the spine. We start with the right foot backwards. Und 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice and up. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. To the side. Up. 2, nice and high. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Change side. Backwards. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. To the side. 2, 3. Lift your knee high. 5, 6. Just because I can't see you, don't get lazy. 10. Change side. Backwards. Heel up. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and outside, 2, 3, 4, 5, so from the direction it's like a dog peeing on a tree, then you're perfect, and 9, 10, change side, backwards, 2, 3, 4, again try to feel that you don't let your belly drop forwards too much, they stay with your low back, continue, 9, 10, and outside, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, stay high, 10, change side, backwards, last round, 3, 4, pull your belly button into the spine, don't let it drop forward, 9, 10, and outwards, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, stay high, make it burn, 5, 6, 7, 8, oh, I betrayed you, sorry, 10, change side, backwards, 2, 3, heel to the ceiling, pull your belly button and then up, 9, 10, and outwards, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, release, shake out your booties if you want, then cross your feet and roll back onto your back, nice and slow. Morning, I will just come back to the middle. So like I said, we focus a bit on the glutes and low back this week, little mobilizing exercise, but also strengthening for your backside again. So feet are nicely on the floor, and we just want to tilt the pelvis backwards. Very important little movement. In physio, often people don't really feel what it's meant. Try to just feel that you press your low back slightly down and release. Just try 3 times this little pelvic tilt. So imagine your belly button wants to pull towards the floor and you should feel your bum cheek slightly lift. So let's try to be precise in this movement. So just tilt your pelvis backwards one last time and release. Next time we roll up. So that means tilt the pelvis and let the movement continue. So roll up nice and slow, vertebra by vertebra, until we are in the shoulder bridge, and then we roll down again nice and precise. Only release the pelvis in the end, chuck. We do 2 more here, so tilt backwards, roll up nice and slow. Feel at all times that your belly button wants to fall through the back down and roll down. And 1 more here, so tilt the pelvis back and roll up. Stay up here, stay there, everybody in the shoulder bridge. Keep your hips now on one level and straighten one foot. Make sure the thighs are parallel. Point your foot. Hold for 5 more. 3, 2, 1. Change side. Stay here. Straighten your left foot. Thighs are parallel. Foot is pointed. Stay here for 3 more. 2, 1. Foot down and roll down vertebra by vertebra. Release your pelvis in the end. 1 more round. So tilt your pelvis backwards. Sorry, 2 more rounds. Roll up. And straighten your foot. Hold here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And foot down, change sides, straighten the other foot, thighs are parallel, hold for three more, two, one, foot down and roll down one more time. So precisely tilt the pelvis backwards, continue the movement, roll up until you are in the shoulder bridge, feel your low belly is active, the belly button's falling down, straighten your right foot for five. Four, keep your hips parallel. Don't let it drop. Stay there. Push yourself up from the floor and up and down. Change side. Left leg. Keep here parallel. And three, two, one. Foot down. Roll down vertebra by vertebra. Grab your knees and come up one more time like in the beginning. So we are already getting towards the last exercise, which is stretching for the hip flexor. It's crucial for the low back because the iliopsoas is attaching at the low back, at the lumbar spine. So let's stretch that one. I will show from here. Make sure your hips are nice and parallel. One big step forward. So if you have a cushion close, get the cushion if you want to put it under here, your back knee, just for a little support. And we want to have the front leg 90 degrees when we are in a stretch, so walk a bit forward with your foot, pull the belly button in and up, and then lean forward. As soon as you're bent in your hip, the stretch will be gone. So make sure here really you pull the belly button towards the spine. And then if you touch your hip bone here, feel it wants to go forward. It doesn't want to go down, but forward and up. And then you should feel the stretch nicely in front of your hip. So it continues from here. Stay there. Breathe into the stretch. Feel into your bum cheek and your thigh. Try to relax there. And then we add a little side bend. So bend to the side. The iliopsoas has two functions. It's flexing the hip, but it's also side bending in the lumbar spine. So here, I mean, probably most of you know that anyway, but here you can stretch it in both of its functions. Breathe into the stretch. Always when you stretch, take time to let go. That's first. I always think stretching is almost a bit of a concentrating exercise, really. Feel into this area and try to check, let go. Also try to be soft in your shoulder. I have to say, I was really looking forward to this stretch. I was dreaming of it tonight. I hope you enjoy it as well. And one more nice breath here. Then slowly come out. Do a free movement if you want. And then we change side. So one step forward from the other side. Walk nicely forward with your foot. Make sure your hips stay beside each other. Don't open here. Pull the belly button in and up towards your spine and then lean forward into the stretch. So what I do in class here mostly is go around, and often there are people that are open, and then I take the hip and push it slightly forward. So try to see for yourself if you want to send your hip bone here more forward and up again. If you don't feel the stretch, check if you are a bit too much forward. Try to be again nice and upright here. When you feel the stretch here nicely, then you can add the side bend. So when we stretch our right leg, we bend over to the left side. Breathe into the stretch. Check on your front foot one more time. Is your heel still under your knee? Check your bum cheek, your thigh. Try to have it nice and relaxed. So that's a muscle also that tends a lot to get tight. And that can really provoke problems in the low back. That's pretty current, pretty often in physiotherapy you see that. Especially when you are working at a desk, you sit a lot, this muscle is in a shortened position all the time and tends to get short or tight. So if that's true for you, that you have problems with your low back, then always check on your iliopsoas. So then from here, slowly release, make a clean movement. So, and this was the last exercise for today. I hope you liked it. Feel free to always contact me for questions afterwards, either here in the chat or also straight on Instagram, which is I Got Your Back Berlin. I'm happy to get your feedback or also questions regarding the class or whatever. And I wish you a happy day. Stay healthy. Enjoy the sun. And hope to see you soon again. Bye-bye. Ciao. Thanks for coming.